one new beginning to another. It's the day Gypsy mum Danielle's always dreamt of.
He's the love of my life.
I feel nervous.
My mom and dad are getting married today and I'm really excited.
Ain't that beautiful? It's exactly how I had.
The dress that Sandra Tilly had made for my daughters, oh my God, they were absolutely gorgeous. I was so touched by it, I wanted to cry.
I love the dress. It's pretty.
I mean, Alexis, I could just see she lit up as soon as she put hers on.
I look like a beautiful gypsy princess.
Now it's the bride's turn to get dressed.
I was totally nervous. I thought, what if it don't fit right? What if it's something I don't like?
This is no ordinary dress.
Ah!
It has layer upon layer upon layer.
Heavy.
That's like super tight.
Danielle's floral creation took 250 yards of tulle, 50 yards of white silk taffeta, 100 crystal flowers, and dozens of rhinestone appliques.
The dress is beautiful. I was lost for words.
Yeah, I'm ready.
At the venue, wedding guests are starting to gather. Todd's gorger family, headed up by his Aunt Jennifer, is on one side of the room. Danielle's gypsy mum, Sandy, and her friends are on the other.
Todd's family do not approve of Danielle. They don't like gypsies, so why would I kiss their ass and like them?
When I first got there, I was tense because it was just me and my kids and, of course, Sandy and all her people, so I didn't know quite what to expect.
She may feel uncertain around gypsies, but Aunt Jennifer's mood soon lifts with the arrival of the groom and his best man.
Todd and Christopher, they both looked adorable, I thought. I've never seen either one of them in a suit. I would like to see Danielle in a traditional gown, but it'll be a gypsy, blinged out gown. I just hope it don't have lights.
It may not have lights, but Danielle is sure to shine.
Damn it, my freaking hips, they all hurt me.
It was like so hectic getting out the doors, squeezing through doors.
Push me through.
But just before she makes her entrance.
Oh, here it comes. Ah.
A wardrobe malfunction and a petticoat is on the ground.
The whole bottom piece of my dress just comes all the way off, hits the ground, everything. I get pushed into the kitchen.
While Todd waits patiently for his bride, the catering staff carry out emergency repairs in the kitchen.
Can you breathe?
No.
That's good then. That's a good sign.
Can't
breathe, that's good.
But I don't care how bad it hurts, how bad it squeezes, pulls, tugs, cuts, rips, long as it fits. The caterers are the only people that save the day for that dress.
This is my fucking wedding day.
When I saw my daughter walking down the aisle as the music started playing in that dress, I mean, it was just breathtaking. And then I saw Danielle. She was gorgeous.
The dress was beautiful. Danielle was amazing.
I'm looking around the place. He was standing there, you know, in his tuxedo. I mean, it was like we was the perfect match, you know.
But not everyone is feeling the love.
I'm not very happy. I did not want her marrying a gorger, especially that gorger.
Family and friends.
The ceremony was about to start. I started getting like butterflies. You could probably see it on my face that I was stunned.
Disapproving mum Sandy sees something else on her future son-in-law's face.
You should be happy, Todd.
All right.
That's her day. That boy did not look happy. And it really, really went to my head. Oh, it blew it.
I'm only gonna keep my mouth shut for so long.
My blood start boiling. My daughter walked up here and you act like you weren't even happy marrying her.
Get the fuck out, bitch.
My mom was like, trying, I mean, to provoke Todd in any way she could. I mean, with all of it.
I got up and tried to get my 2 and 4-year-old granddaughter out of the room.
Please leave your hands off of me.
Stop.
People, security, whatever's, you know, proceeding to take my mother out of the wedding.
I get angry, everything turns like black. I'm not playing this, like, I don't know when to stop.
Jet, go! No,
Sandy gone. Lashes out at the nearest gorger.
Oh my God!
I knew it was my daughter that she had just hit in the back of the head, so I charged Sandy.
And I yell out, she just hit my fucking mom.
Now that two Queen Bees are fighting, conflict soon escalates.
It was a brawl. It was an all-out brawl.
When the best man landed on my wedding cake, I knew it was over.
Glass started being thrown. You could hear nothing but screaming. It was just chaos.
Sandy was throwing vases like hand grenades. All she heard was crash, glass shattering everywhere.
Get the fuck back!
It was like a wedding from hell. It should have been my big, fat, American, Gypsy hell wedding.
Jenny manages to get her nephew Todd outside.
Please get in the car.
Don't let me, Todd.
Todd, get in the car. We'll call. Let's go.
Get in the car!
Hey, Joe!
I can't even believe she would do that. Sandy Harris ruined the wedding before it even started. I grabbed a cane. I started beating on the window.
He gets more than he bargained from Sandy's friends.
The next thing I know, I see these two guys coming toward me. I trip. I heard Amber trying to pull them off me. But that was a big help.
Gypsies, homeboy!
One of the first times in my life, the cops started pulling up and everything. You know, I was actually happy.
In less than 15 minutes, Danielle and Todd's dream wedding lies in ruins.
I honestly think that nobody wanted this wedding to happen.
I wish that Todd would use this as a wake-up call to see this is not something he wants to commit to for the rest of his life.
They ain't gonna stay together. It ain't gonna last. Todd ain't got a foot to stand on.
My mom sabotaged everything.
One minute, it's the most amazing feeling of my life. Next minute, it felt like my life was over.
It's the day after the failed wedding.
Gonna need you to just sign a few documents, and then everything will be official.
In defiance of their gorger and gypsy families alike, Todd and Danielle have come to the courthouse.
Sandy Harris didn't do nothing about this big of a delay of us getting married.
So, we'll just have you sign that.
I love
it. You guys are official. Congratulations.
Yeah, I got married to a gorger level. Hell yeah.
I want everybody to know how happy we are.
Love conquers all.
Exactly.